Oh, me and my cousin went off the McBride as we went to walking down by the seaside. Well, mark you what followed and what did betide, for it being Christmas morning. And for recreation we went on a tramp, and we met Sergeant Napper and Corporal Vamp, and a little wee drummer intending a camp, for the day being pleasant and charming. Good morning, the sergeant did cry, and the same to you gentlemen we did reply, and meaning no harm, but we went to pass by, for it being Christmas morning. But said he, if you fellows should want to enlist, it's 10 guineas in gold that will slip in your fist, and a crown in the bargain for to kick up the dust and drink the king's health in the morning. For soldier he leads a very fine life, and he always is blessed with a charming young wife, and he pays all his debts without sorrow or strife, and he always lives pleasant and charming. And a soldier he always is decent and clean, in the finest of clothing he's constantly seen, while other poor fellows look dirty and mean, and sup on thin gruel in the morning. Said Arthur, I wouldn't be proud of your clothes, for you've only the lend of them, as I suppose, and you dare not change them one night, for you know, if you did, you'd be flogged in the morning. And although we may be simple and free, we take great delight in our own company, and we have no desire strange places to see, although that your offer is charming. And we have no desire to take your advance, all hazards and dangers we barter on chance, and you'd have no scruples for to send us to France, where we would be shot without warning. Oh no, said the sergeant, I'll have no such chat, and I neither will take it from scoundrel or brat. And if you insult me with one other word, I'll cut off your heads in the morning. And Arthur and I, we soon drew our hogs, and we gave them no time to draw their own blades, when a trusty shillelagh came over their heads, and bid them take that as fair warning. And the old rusty rapiers that hung by their sides, we flung them as far as we could in the tide. And take them up, devils, cried Arthur McBride, and temper their edge in the morning. And the little wee drummer, we flattened his bow, and we made a football of his rowdy dow-dow, threw it in the tide for to rock and to roll, and bade it a tedious returning. And having no money, we paid them in cracks, and we paid no respect to their two bloody backs, and we lathered them there like a pair of wet sacks, and left them for dead in the morning. And so to conclude and to settle disputes, we obligingly asked if they wanted recruits, for we were the lads who would give them hard clouts and bid them look sharp in the morning. Oh, me and my cousin were Arthur McBride, as we went a walking down by the seaside. Now mark you what followed and what did betide, for it being Christmas morning.